position. Because Tyler, let's be fair, TL looked great today. In many parts. They looked terrific. Unfortunately, fate was not in their hands, but we have to give them credit. They won. They got stomped against G2. Okay, let's be fair. They got soundly defeated against G2 in that rematch, but then they defeated Machi and they defeated Suning in impressive fashion. And when NA fans were watching those two games, that hope was building, man.
Dominant.
Like, in that moment, we were like, okay, this is what we wanted to see, especially when they beat Suning. It was like, this is a team we can get behind. And remember, this was the team that we all got behind, or many people in NA got behind, on paper before Worlds even started.
Yeah, a tiebreaker versus Suning would have been exciting, especially when we just talked about it. Suning is a team that does prep well, and they're very mechanically gifted, but they're young, and they can get nervy, and they can play too far forward. We saw that with Hyungfang in the tiebreaker versus G2 on his Ashe, where he was far too forward so many times, and he got caught so many times. And obviously, that didn't kill Suning because they were so far ahead. But there was these moments where Suning did play a bit too risky, a bit too far forward. If it was a do-or-die match to stay inside the tournament, those stakes heightened so far more, where Team Liquid and these level ones they were pulling out that were taking the fight to these teams and basically saying, Core JJ is better than you, and he is going to find the perfect engage, and we are going to get First Blood and get our jungler rolling, get Proxer rolling. I wish we could have seen that tiebreaker. Usually I would have been very forlorn and very scared of what we and I have seen from North American tiebreaker versus an LPL team at Worlds, especially when we looked back at last year when IG just mollywopped Team Liquid across the floor, and I had to watch it live. And, man, that was a bloody, bloody battering that I had to witness with the Shy kind of just flame horizing Impact in like the first 10 minutes. It was bad, but that would have been a very eventful, and I think Team Liquid could have gone in very confident, especially after those two victories. And then G2 lost, and I think a lot of people are going to look at that and say G2 screwed NA. Oh man, like, it's unfair. North America should have had that chance. Like, why couldn't have G2, you know, drafted something better? And obviously, you know, I mauled it. I got a bit salty. I'm like, I know G2 can play better than what they did, and not, you know, especially the first game. I mean, the second game, a lot closer, but the first game where they just got destroyed, you know, I mauled it. I was like, they could play better, but it's not G2's fault. G2 earned the right to play whatever composition they wanted because they beat Machi. Suning was allotted the same, you know, a freedom to play around with their compositions because they beat Machi in both of their games. This tournament, this entire group stage, it's going to go back to that first game, that first day when I told you, Arda, one of the most embarrassing losses in North American League of Legends history, when Team Liquid got rolled over by Machi, a team that self-proclaimed did not believe they would win a game in this group. They thought they were going to go 0-6, but Team Liquid was fast asleep at the wheel, didn't do anything, played far too passive, just let Machi roll over them, and they dropped a game to a team they shouldn't have. We saw today, Team Liquid, in probably the biggest blow of the entire tournament, just smacked around Machi from the level one to the end of the game, around 25 minutes. It was not close. So it all goes back to that first game where that one game is going to haunt Team Liquid. It's not going to be the games that they lost to G2. They went 1-1 with G2 and 1-1 with Suning. But when it came down to it, you have to 2-0 Machi, the weakest team in the group, the team that thought they would go 0-6, and that is what's going to be lingering with them forever. Because past Team Liquid teams, they usually lost to the top teams. They would get destroyed by IG. They would get destroyed by KT Rolster. They would take care of business against the weak teams, but they would look so outmatched against the top teams. What makes this like failing, this third place feel so bittersweet and so melancholy is that they played the best teams well. They had blowout victories versus Suning. They dominated G2 in one of these games. Yes, you can talk about draft all you want, but they outdrafted these teams. That's impressive in itself. And it's something where it's like they could have done something. Where in past you could say like, yeah, they were just weaker than these teams. They weren't up to snuff. They couldn't touch, you know, KT or IG. They beat Suning. They beat G2. It's that one loss versus Machi that's going to just hold them back, where they played so better, much better after those first two games, where they were proactive. They were enabling Brock. So they were fighting for those level ones. They were invading. They were taking their own destiny in their own hands, and they were enabling what makes them great. And it's Core JJ is their best player. When you can believe in Core JJ to set up those engages, and they were just so better in the latter half of this tournament, where the week two NA meme is they are actually a lot better in week two. So that Machi, like, yeah, the Machi loss is going to sting for them the most. It's not the G2 losing to Suning. G2 earned that right by beating Machi twice. They had his hope, and the hope went sideways. And I don't think G2 threw that for any, you know, matter of fact. I think they really did want to just get the first seed, because who doesn't want to get the first seed? But, man, that Machi.
I think it's fun to meme that. Yeah. Obviously, it's social media content. It's funny. Completely understand. But I don't buy any team throwing a game, especially at a world championship. If G2 had won that game, they would have automatically been the first seed. So that, like, I just don't see that being the case. I will say, just a quick sidebar here, for Machi, good for them that they were able to get a victory like that. I mean, that is an important victory for them.
Yes.
It's just like you said, they didn't think that they'd have anyone. Draft or not, even looking beyond the draft, and TL didn't have the best draft in that game where they lost, but still, it doesn't matter. What matters is they got a victory, and TL got it back in the end, but we always thought, Tyler, that Machi would be the fourth place team in this group, and they ended up being the fourth place team, but it wasn't without at least a little bit of pride coming their way.
No, there's a lot of credit to Machi, and again, it's a situation where, yes, Team Liquid should be kicking themselves, and it should be a game that they look back on, but it's similar to when Team Liquid upset IG at MSI semifinals, right? Where, you know, IG has to be kicking themselves that they lost to Team Liquid, and that was their chance to, you know, win back-to-back international titles, and that, you know, they should have been Team Liquid, but they didn't. And Team Liquid planned for them that day. Team Liquid played at a 10, Invictus Gaming played at a 5 or 6, and Team Liquid took advantage. And that's not taking anything away from Team Liquid. We should always be proud of that victory for Team Liquid. It's probably the best victory we've ever had in North American history, alongside the Cloud9 3-0 versus Afrika from the 2018 Worlds. And very similar here, where Team Liquid should be kicking themselves, they should be mad at themselves, they should be saying, we are good enough to make top 8, we should have pushed this we should have pushed this to 20 tiebreakers, we are at the level of G2 in Suning. We can fight with these guys. Maybe they're better than us, maybe they're better, and we would still have finished third in a long tiebreaker, but they felt like they were on the same plane as those guys. And I think they earned it by going 1-1. But Machi, well-deserved, they took advantage of a sleeping Team Liquid. And it wasn't something where Team Liquid just kind of, you know, gave the game away. It was Machi taking the game for themselves. Gemini and Mission in that game just destroyed their opposition, where Gemini was far more active than Broxa. And Mission was up 30-40 CS on Syndra against Jensen and made him irrelevant. So for Machi, I think this might be the only victory for PCS throughout the entire tournament. I don't have high hopes for PSG Talon tomorrow versus Damwon, Rogue, and JD Gaming, which is such a killer group. So
still winner storyline-wise in my books, especially from the play-ins. But I agree with you.